إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كلام الله سبحانه وتعالى For indeed the best of speech is the speech of Allah وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم And the best of guidance is the guidance of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها And the worst of all affairs are those newly invented matters to the deen of Allah وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار and every newly invented matter that is introduced to the deen of Allah it is ضلالة it is going astray and every going astray is an innovation and leads to the hellfire ثم ما بعد عباد الله قال الله سبحانه وتعالى أو قد حثنا الله سبحانه وتعالى على فعل ما يوجب المغفرة ويوجب الجنة. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded us and incites us to do that which bring us the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and make us from the people of Jannah. ومن الآيات الدالة على ذلك الآيات في سورة آل عمران. قال الله سبحانه wa ta'ala وسارعوا إلى مغفرة من ربكم وجنة عرضها السماوات والأرض أعدت للمتقين الذين ينفقون في السراء والضراء والكاظمين الغيظ والعافين عن الناس والله يحب المحسنين والذين إذا فعلوا فاحشة أو ظلموا أنفسهم ذكروا الله فاستغفروا لذنوبهم ومن يغفر الذنوب إلا الله ولم يصروا على ما فعلوا وهم يعلمون أولئك لهم مغفرة من ربهم وجنات وجنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار خالدين فيها ونعم أجر العاملين Many are the ayats in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the Jannah, mentioned paradise, mentioned the way that leads to it from the forgiveness and doing actions of worship, the good actions that leads to paradise. From these ayats, as we mentioned, these ayats from 133 to 136 in Surah Ali Imran, and we'll read to you, inshallah, the English translation for this ayats. So we give you the accurate translation as from the Noble Quran, inshallah. قال الله سبحانه وتعالى وسارعوا إلى مغفرة من ربكم وجنة عرضها السماوات والأرض أعدت للمتقين and march forth in the way which leads to forgiveness from your Lord. And for paradise, as wide as the heavens and the earth, prepared for al-muttaqoon. الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ فِي السَّرَّاءِ وَالدَّرَّاءِ وَالْكَاظِمِينَ الْغَيْظَ وَالْعَافِينَ عَنِ النَّاسِ وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ Those who spend in Allah's cause in prosperity and adversity, who repress anger and who pardon men, verily Allah loves al-muhsinun, the good doers. وَالَّذِينَ إِذَا فَعَلُوا فَاحِشَةً أَوْ ظَلَمُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ ذَكَرُوا اللَّهَ فَاسْتَغْفَرُوا لِذُنُوبِهِمْ وَمَنْ يُغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ وَلَمْ يُصِرُّوا عَلَى مَا فَعَلُوا وَهُمْ يَعْلَمُونَ And they are those who when they have committed fahisha, great sins as illegal sexual intercourse, or wronged themselves with evil, they remember Allah and ask forgiveness for their sins. And none can forgive sins but Allah and do not persist in what wrong they have done while they know. أُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمْ مَغْفِرَةٌ مِنْ رَبِّهِمْ وَجَنَّاتٍ تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارُ خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا وَنِعْمَ أَجْرُ الْعَامِلِينَ For such the reward is forgiveness from their Lord and gardens with rivers flowing underneath, meaning paradise. wherein they shall abide forever. How excellent is this reward for the good doers, those who do righteous deeds according to the commands and the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. من أهل العلم من العلماء الذين ذكروا في تفاسيرهم معنى هذه الآيات الإمام القرطبي رحمه الله تعالى. From the great scholars, amongst the scholars of Islam who mentioned the tafsir of these ayat, is the great Imam, al-Imam al-Qurtubi, a great Imam from the A'imma of the Salaf. He mentioned in his tafsir, وَسَارِعُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ أَيْ سَارِعُوا إِلَى مَا يُوجِبُ الْمَغْفِرَةِ مِنْ فِعْلِ الطَّاعَاتِ. سَارِعُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ يعني سَارِعُوا إِلَى مَا يُوجِبُ ذَلِكَ مِنْ فِعْلِ الطَّاعَاتِ. الإمام القرطبي رحمه الله, he says, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, and march forth in the way which leads to the forgiveness of your Lord. He said, meaning by doing acts of obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's what brings forgiveness of Allah. When you do acts that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ordered and commanded, that's how we earn the forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The forgiveness of Allah is not earned through someone who goes to some dead person in some grave and ask him so that Allah forgive him. This is not the right way. That's shirk akbar wal'iyadu billah. The forgiveness, it is sought from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And how? By being obedient to him subhanahu wa ta'ala, and being obedient to his messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, by doing righteous deeds. That's what leads to forgiveness. وقال الإمام ابن كثير رحمه الله تعالى في تفسيره العظيم قال بعد أن ذكر الله سبحانه وتعالى بعد صفات أهل النار من الآيات التي قبلها حذر الله سبحانه وتعالى من الربا والذين يتعاملون بالربا وقال واتقوا النار. قال فندب ربنا سبحانه وتعالى إلى فعل الطاعات وأعمال الخيرات التي تؤدي إلى مغفرة الله سبحانه وتعالى وإلى جنات الله سبحانه وتعالى. As for another great imam from the imams of أهل السنة, الحافظ ابن كثير rahimahullah, in his famous and yet very important book of tafsir, he mentioned in the tafsir of this ayat, وَسَارِعُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ, and march forth the forgiveness of your Lord. He says, rahimahullah, that in the ayats before these ones, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has warned his servants against evil actions that leads to the fire, that leads to the wrath of Allah and the punishment of Allah. If you read the ayat 131 and 132, you understand that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was warning against certain actions, evil actions such as riba, dealing with riba and usury and the like. And then Allah says, and fear the fire. Protect yourself from the fire. And Allah tells us, what are the things that will save us from the fire? What are the means and the things that if we do, it will save us from the fire and earn us the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to be from the people of the Jannah. وَسَارِعُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ وَجَنَّةٍ عَرْضُهَا السَّمَاوَاتِ. This is the Jannah. If you read the Quran with contemplation and with reflection, many are the ayats that talks about the Jannah, its bliss, talks about everything he wants to know about it. The food of the people of Jannah. Their clothings. Their dwellings. And even what the ceilings are made of. What the floor is made of. The rivers and the like. These are one of the ayats. So this Jannah is as wide as the heavens and the earth. قال الإمام القرطبي وغيره الإمام ابن كثير يعني هذا لوسعها. They says as wide as the heavens is not restricted to this, but actually that shows how wide and big and huge the Jannah is indeed. وذكر الإمام أحمد رحمه الله تعالى في مسنده وغيره أن رجلا وفي رواية أنه عظيم الروم ملك الروم هرقل أن رجلا سأل رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم: إذا كانت الجنة كما قال الله سبحانه وتعالى جنة عرضها السماوات والأرض، إذن أين النار؟ إذا كانت هذه الجنة عرضها السماوات والأرض، إذن أين النار؟ فقال له رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم: أرأيت إذا أتى الليل أين النهار؟ وأرأيت إذا أتى النهار فأين الليل؟ قال الرجل: حيث شاء الله. قال: كذلك جنة عرضها السماوات والأرض، والنار حيث شاء الله. والحديث صححه الإمام الألباني رحمه الله. In this hadith that is authenticated by الإمام الألباني رحمه الله, and it is صحيح in مسند الإمام أحمد and other than him, that a man, and in a narration, that man, they said, he is the king of Rome, the Romans, the Heracles. That this man asked the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam called him to the Jannah that is as wide as the heavens and the earth, this man said, if the Jannah is as wide as the heavens and the earth, so where is the fire? Where gonna be the hell fire? If the Jannah taking all of this as wide as the heavens and the earth, so where the hell fire is? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to him, gave him an example. He said, when the night comes in, what do you think? Where the day? And when the day comes in, where the night is? The man says, where Allah wish. He says, likewise, the hellfire. Likewise, the same case for the hellfire. على أين يا أخوان هذه الجنة that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala incite us and command us to march for, to compete one another, by doing righteous deeds. And in this ayat, in Surah Al-Imran, he mentions some of the deeds that we should adorn ourselves with, we should pay attention to, and we should act upon. Those amongst us who are doing these actions, alhamdulillah, thank Allah for tawfiq, and ask Allah firmness, and continue to do these deeds. Those amongst us like myself, we're struggling, and we're still trying to get it right, then let us pay attention to this ayat. And of course, we have a limited time. When you go home, review the tafsir. Because we just quote for you. We select something. But you go back home and read the tafsir, walhamdulillah, of tafsir Ibn Kathir, Al-Qurtubi, and Sa'di, and other than them. So we can get more information, inshallah ta'ala, that will help us to put ourselves and to stay, inshallah ta'ala, on the path that leads to the forgiveness of Allah, the path that leads to Garden of Paradise. من صفاتهم لأن الله أعدها للمتقين. In many ayats, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned that the Jannah is for the muttaqoon. إِنَّ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ مَفَازًا إِنَّ الْمُتَّقِينَ فِي جَنَّاتٍ وَعُيُونٍ. Many are the ayats where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned that the Jannah is for المتقون. Regardless who you are, what country you come from. The Jannah is for the pious and for the righteous. Those who do the commands of, act upon the commands of Allah to the best of their ability, stay away from the prohibitions. Those who often repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and they do righteous deeds for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إذن من صفاتهم ماذا؟ الذين ينفقون في السراء والضراء. من صفاتهم أنهم ينفقون. إذا وسع الله عليهم وعندهم خير كثير ينفقون خيرا كثيرا. ولكن إذا كانوا غير ميسورين ومعسرين ينفقون مما آتاهم الله. ينفقون على الأقارب، الأقربون أولى بالمعروف. ينفقون على اليتامى والأرامل. ينفقون على المحتاجين والمدينين. لماذا؟ لأنهم يريدون أن يكونوا من أهل الجنة. The first of the characteristics in this ayat, that from the muttaqoon, that they will earn the forgiveness of Allah, and they will be admitted in the Jannah, that they spend, Allahu Akbar. They spend in the times of prosperity and times of adversity. Ibn Kathir, rahimahullah, says, meaning those that Allah has given them a lot of wealth, they rich, they spend a lot. According to the word Allah has given them. If they have a lot of wealth, they spend a lot. They take care of their families first, their parents, their wives, their children, their family members. And then they take care and help out the needy, such as the poor, such as the masakeen, such as the orphans and the widows, people that going through hardship, people that they have debts and they cannot pay those debts, they look at those people and help them out. They spend. Why they do all this? Because they want to be from these people that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has praised and has mentioned that He has prepared for them forgiveness and gardens of paradise as wide as the heavens and the earth. And they are be from the muttaqun. Likewise, this spending is not limited nor it is restricted only for the rich people. Also those who are poor. Yes, you're going through hardship. Your resources are limited, but you still want to spend according to your means. You spend according to your means so that you can be among these people that Allah has praised in the Quran. وَالْكَاظِمِينَ الْغَيْضَ وَالْعَافِينَ عَنِ النَّاسِ. One of the characteristics from the people of Jannah, الْكَاظِمِينَ الْغَيْضَ. Allahu Akbar. Those who repress anger and who pardon men. الكاظمين الغيظ. قال ابن كثير رحمه الله تعالى في تفسيره يعني إذا غضبوا كتموا الغيظ ولم يعملوه لم يعملوا بهذا الغضب. نعم أنت إنسان تغضب وكثيرة هي الأمور التي تغضبك، لكن تريد أن تكون الله لم يقل لا يغضبون، لا الغضب، لكن لا يعمل بمقتضى الغضب بل يصبر ويحتسب. وأحسن من ذلك أنه يعفو عمن ظلمه. لهذا قال الله سبحانه وتعالى والله يحب المحسنين. الله أكبر. So one of the characteristics, they are those who repress anger. Allah says they repress anger. So Allah didn't say they don't get angry. We're human. Yes, there are things that make us angry. But to be from these people is that when you're angry, don't act upon anger. Do not act upon anger. Repress it. Yes, you really want to say a lot of things. You want to do a lot of things. But you're not. Why? Because you remember this ayat. Because you want to be from the muttaqun. You want to be from the people of Jannah. You want to be from those that earn the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yes, you can say whatever like other people. When they're angry, they curse, they slander. Some even fight. Some destroy everything around them. But no. Yes, you may able to do all that. You're a strong person. You have a tongue, you can speak. But you're not. You're repressing it. You're keeping it to yourself. You're not acting upon anger. Why? Because you want to be from these people that Allah mentioned in this ayah. And remember that the strong person, as the Prophet ﷺ tells it in a sound hadith, that is in Sahih al-Bukhari, Sahih Muslim, from the authority of Abu Huraira, it is not the one who throw out people and overpower them because of his strength. قَالَ صَلَى اللَّهُ وَسَلَّمْ لَيْسَ الشَّدِيدُ بِالسُّرَعَةِ إِنَّمَا الشَّدِيدُ الَّذِي يَمْلِكُ نَفْسَهُ عِنْدَ الْغَدَبِ. A strong man is not the one who overpower the people and throw them everywhere to show his strength, but the strong man is the one who subdue himself and repress his anger in a time of anger. A man came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He says, "Awsini." قال لا تغضب. كرر ذلك ثلاثة. A man came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and he said to him, "Advise me. Give me advice." He said, "Do not." The literally translation is, "Do not become angry." Mimi said that three times, but the ulama they says it means don't act upon anger. When you're angry, do not act upon that. Because a lot of people, they do a lot of things. They cause harm to others, to themselves. They put themselves, a lot of people in jail. People are dead. People are in trouble because they act upon anger. So, what is the meaning of the hadith, the ulama, they says? Stay away from anything that lead you to be angry. If you go to places and they get you angry, you're around people that provoke you and you be angry, stay away from these things. Unless if you have to, like a job, family members, then you have to deal with that according to your situation. But people that you don't have to be with, stay away from them. Places that make you angry, you don't go there anymore. But places that you have to be, it's like, for example, people in your family, then you have to evaluate. You have a job, then you have to evaluate your situation according to what you can do. And also, when you're angry, do not act upon it. And better than this, subhanAllah, not acting upon anger, is to pardon and forgive those who harm you. SubhanAllah, it's difficult. It's not easy to do these things. But this is Jannah we're talking about. You think Jannah is easy? No, well, yeah, it's difficult. Now somebody curse you out, somebody send you a nasty text message, somebody say, I'm going to get you, I'm going to this, and what you do? Yes, you can send 10 nasty messages, not just one. You can call other people and go meet him somewhere. But a Muslim is not a gang. Muslims are not gangs. Muslims, they pay attention to what Allah says, because our stay is limited in this life. But the real life is the life of the hereafter. And we know this journey of ours will lead us to two destinations. When this journey on this life will come to an end, then it is only two destinations. As Allah tells us, فَرِيقٌ فِي الْجَنَّةِ وَفَرِيقٌ فِي السَّعِيرِ. A group will be in the Jannah, while the other group will be in the hellfire. We're not even going to ask a question, which group you want to be with. We ask Allah to make us from the people of Jannah. أَقُولُ مَا تَسْمَعُونَ وَأَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ. الحمد لله الذي أرسل رسوله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله وكفى بالله شهيدا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له إقرارا به وتوحيدا وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا أما بعد عباد الله أيها المسلمون قال الله سبحانه وتعالى كذلك Allah سبحانه وتعالى mentioning some of the qualities and the characteristics of the people of Jannah. Those who are muttaqoon, those that will earn his forgiveness, subhanahu wa ta'ala, and those who will be admitted in these gardens of paradise. And we all know what Allah has prepared for the muttaqoon. In them, ja'ali Allahu ayyakum minhum, qal walladhina idha fa'alu fahishatan aw zalamu anfusahum, dhakaru Allaha wastaghfaru li dhunubihim. And they are those from the characteristics of the people of the Jannah, that when they wrong themselves, keep in mind, we're human. We're not perfect. We're not prophets. We're human. We got a lot of shortcomings. You have to acknowledge that. You got to say to yourself, look, I got a lot of issues. And know your issues. You should know what's wrong with you. The same way you want to know what's wrong with the car you drive. If the car give you a little bit of noise that not normal, you pull over and you call. What's wrong with it? Is it going to let the engine? Because you know the consequences if you keep driving a car. It just happened to me yesterday, by the way. Allah musta'an. Now, a lot of people, they're very serious about their cars. Some people, they even check the oil twice a day. I know certain people, before they get in the car, they pop the hood. What happened? Got to check the oil. So you checked it yesterday. Now I got to check it every day. Do we check our actions every day? Do we check our actions every day? What did we do today? In the morning, do you check what did you do yesterday? So that just in case if you've done something wrong, you correct it. You ask Allah for forgiveness. In the morning, in the evening, do we take a time out and say, what have I done today? Did I act upon the what Allah ordered me to act upon? Have I said something that is not right? Have I robbed anyone so you can ask forgiveness? Because once you put your head on a pillow and you don't know if you're going to make it next morning. You're not going to know. When a death comes to you, you cannot say, give me some time. الموت لا ينتظرك حتى تستقيم. استقم وأنت تنتظر الموت. Death doesn't wait for anyone until he get it together and be upright and be righteous. Should do it the other way around. We should get our things together and be righteous while we're waiting for death. Now, this is the attitude of a Muslim. Muslim doesn't eat, drink, sleep, go here and every day. No, you're going to check. You check the bills. You check your fridge. You check everything. You check your money if you want to travel, if you want to do anything, how much you have, how much you need. But now when you come to the matters of the Jannah, you're just going to keep going? Whatever, alhamdulillah, Allah ghafur rahim, ya Allah ghafur rahim. But it's not like that. Allah commands us to do certain things in certain way, according to what He has legislated, doing it sincerely for Him, for no show off, for no shame, for no gain, for no fame. Rather do things for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ikhlas, and according to the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If me and you, we don't take time from our schedules, and we ask ourselves these questions, what am I doing here? Am I doing what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands me to do? As related to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded me. Fulfill the rights of Allah. Fulfill the rights of your family. Are you really doing what you're supposed to be doing as related to your family, your wife, your children, the wife towards her husband and the like? The rights of your parents, the rights of your neighbors, the rights of your family members. Are we doing all of this? Don't just wait and now you have to put everything in order. If someone has a business, subhanAllah, they don't go to sleep. Spend an hour or two thinking about what happened, how much they made today, what didn't sell, what they need, the inventory, what they need for tomorrow. They're not just going to wait until tomorrow open and the shop is full of customers. Oh, we run out. We have no eggs. Oh, we don't have this. La, they do that before they go to sleep. Before they go to sleep, they have the slip. And they already made an order. And that order, they want to make sure. Even they pay extra for delivery. We need this order by 5 o'clock in the morning. Why? Because that's their business. They don't want to come open and, we don't have this. And we don't have that. And we don't have that. And then customers start going away. So do we do the same thing for ourselves? What have you do? The things that keep you on the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as related to our belief, our aqidah, as related to things we say, the things we do, actions of worship, our manners, our akhlaq, our behavior. Na'am ibadallah. These are the characteristics of the people of Jannah. When they wrong themselves, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, kullukum khata' wa khairul khata'in at-tawabun. All of you wrong yourselves. But the best of those who wrong themselves, those who repent afterwards. That's what Allah tells us. Those who wrong themselves. He didn't say those who do not wrong themselves. Period. Now we human, we wrong ourselves. Allah says, but when they wrong themselves, they fall into sins, then they repent. They say, enough is enough. This path ain't good for me. It's not going to get me to the Jannah. And I want to be in the Jannah. Because they know that in Yawm al-Qiyamah, if he or she doesn't find themselves in the Jannah, they're going to find themselves in the hellfire. There's only two destinations. And they say, enough is enough. They struggle. They fight. It's not easy. Sometimes it's difficult to get rid of some habits, bad habits. But then they're going to try. If you try, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you tawfiq. But you have to try. You got to follow the means. You got to make efforts. You got to believe in this. You got to take this matter of the Jannah and the hellfire seriously. It's serious. Especially none of us know when he's going to die. If you're 60, and you're still like, I still have like 20 years. Who lied to you? You have nothing. The next moment is not guaranteed for anyone. As we all know and say this, death is certain. Tomorrow is not. As'alullah li lakum at-tawfiq wa sadad. I didn't finish because we run out of time. We may finish next time, inshallah ta'ala. But I will advise all of you, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, to review the tafsir of this ayat, 133 to 136 in Surah Al-Imran. And many are the ayats in the Quran that talks about Jannah and the ahadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that talks about this very important matter. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us beneficial knowledge that produces righteous actions and keep us firm upon the path that lead to his forgiveness, the Jannah. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam tasliman kathira.